but now to the steady realisation that many of us are having regarding the harm that the internet, smartphones and social media in particular, is having within our society and amongst our children especially. And it's got teachers and education experts pretty worried about future generations, with some even calling kids today Generation Zombie as a result. Now, for centuries, humanity has been educated using language, reading, the written word, and that's all been eclipsed now by picture-driven imagery on social media and the dopamine hit that that delivers, meaning it means that young people favour pictures and their phones over the hard learning of books, words and numbers. The situation's become so bad that experts are calling for a complete ban on phones in schools across the country. Joining me now is Jean Yates, a teacher from Queensland. With more than 30 years of experience, she's quite outspoken on this issue. Jean, I really pay tribute to you for having the conversation. I think we're having it at home around the kitchen table, but I don't think we're having enough in the public domain. What have you seen firsthand in relation to social media, smartphones and young people today?
Yeah, thanks very much, Peta. It really is having an impact on them. So they're coming to school, I always say they're tired or wired. So they're either exhausted because they've been up all night on social media, or they're overstimulated because, you know, they're looking at this constant stimulation on their phone, this constant supply of whatever it is that they want to watch. So their attention spans have completely dropped and they just expect to be entertained all the time, you know, so they don't have the capacity to amuse themselves. They can't ever cope with being bored and they're certainly not going to tune into anything that they don't find interesting.
One of the really interesting things I read that all of these tech billionaires in the Silicon Valley, they ban their own kids from devices and social media. Now, doesn't that tell you everything?
Yeah, although I do think we need to be really careful. I don't actually think that banning is the way to go. I think we need to model social media use a little better. And, you know, I don't think there are very many adults out there who wouldn't have to admit that we're all on our phones a bit too much. But I think rather than just banning the phones, banning the social media, we need to support kids to learn how to use them properly, how to develop that digital etiquette, if you like, because at some point they have to have the internal responsibility to decide when it's appropriate to be on devices and when it's not. And also, if we ban them and then the kids are exposed to something threatening online, they're not going to be prepared to seek help because they're going to be afraid that they're going to be in trouble. So we actually need to know what our kids are looking at, keep the lines of dialogue open and talk to them about the things that they might be seeing online.
You and I, Jean, though, we can remember a time when you went out for dinner and you weren't sitting on your devices. I mean, I often go out for dinner and I look around restaurants and see mum and dad on devices, kids on devices. I see couples out for a hot date and they're both on devices. I mean, it's just crazy, right? So we can remember life before devices. I know myself, I use my phone for work constantly. I feel sometimes, you know, I can't watch TV without also looking at my device, and I say, that's enough. Put it away. Put it in a drawer. Put it away. But if you're growing up and all you know is life with a device, how do you moderate it?
It's like anything. Anything that you do obsessively is going to be dangerous for you. So, you know, every generation has had this problem. We all were worried about the printing press destroying society and about movies destroying society and so on. So every generation has had this challenge. It's just that we have to learn to moderate it, and it needs to be internally moderated as well as externally moderated. And, you know, as I said, adults need to model that there are times that phones need to be put away. I think it's probably why we're all feeling particularly stressed and particularly tired, because we don't have a distinction now between work time and socializing because we're on the same devices all the time.